In the previous step, you chose which items to sync from one tool to another. Now you can choose which individual fields within your work items you'd like to keep in sync. You can choose whether to have Unito auto-map fields automatically or do it manually yourself. For example, if you have a task in one tool and you only care about the title and description, you don't need to add any other fields to your flow. Or you can add as many as you can think of. It all depends on your use case and preferences. You can add a new field mapping by clicking the button at the top. Your new mapping will then appear at the top of the list. Typically, you'll want to pair it with the same or a similar field in your other tool. If there is no obvious or compatible match for a field in another tool, our users often select the description footer so the data has somewhere to go that can still be accessed by a team using that tool. If you see a cog or gear icon beside a field mapping, you can click on it to view the options associated with that mapping. In the case of labels, tags, or lists, you can add or modify values to match different names between tools. For example, you could tell Unito that the in-progress list in tool A maps to the active list in tool B. You can map one-to-one or one-to-many, giving you lots of flexibility. Perhaps there are a variety of statuses in one tool that all equal a single status in another. For example, to-do and in-progress in tool A might all equal incomplete in tool B. It may not be possible to map some fields with others. If that's the case, you can submit a support request to find a workaround from our team or ask about enhancement. If you decide to add a new field to your tool while editing mappings, you'll need to refresh the page in order for Unito to detect it. Sub-items, such as subtasks and checklists, will follow your flow directions behavior at all times and also count as items in sync.